Hey everyone, how's it going? My name is Zach Cox, and today what we got for you are some Red Dead Redemption Easter eggs within GTA 5. And so far I've counted 14. There may be more, but these are like all the ones that I know of, and I've been searching for a while now. And with Red Dead Redemption 2 on the horizon, it's like half a year away now. I figured what better way to like usher in this new era of a Rockstar game than counting down every single Red Dead Redemption Easter egg within GTA 5. So if you guys find the video enjoyable, be sure to give it a thumbs up. Let's try and break 1,000 likes if you are excited, of course, for Red Dead Redemption 2. And be sure to subscribe as well to never miss out. But with that said, let's go ahead and get started with all of these Red Dead Redemption Easter eggs in GTA 5. So I've got these scattered out in no particular order, from big Easter eggs to small ones, vice versa. And the first one we have is Red's Salvage Yard, which can be found in Polito Bay. And the Easter egg in this area is actually just on the sign. It's called Red's Salvage Yard. If we take a look at the sign, we can see that it features the same font that Red Dead Redemption did, and it's called Red's. So I'd say right there is a red flag, no pun intended, just implying that this is a Red Dead Redemption Easter egg. Now moving on to another small one we have, it can actually be found in three different locations throughout Los Santos. We have the Cafe Redemption, and we have the name Redemption in the name, so we can kind of guess and assume, I guess you could say, that this is a reference to Red Dead Redemption, as well as, if that's not enough, we have this logo, and it is of a hog, and it's very similar to the hogs that can be found within Red Dead Redemption. And in this game, hogs were a very valuable item. You could trade them for meat, make some money off of them, and just different things like that. So I'd say this is another little minor obvious reference and hint and Easter egg to Red Dead Redemption. Now this next one is one of these minor ones, but it's also very cool. So we've got Michael DeSanta. We know that's his surname or his last name. And then in Red Dead Redemption, we actually have a character by the name of Captain Vincent DeSanta. And he's a major character in this game. He's also a secondary antagonist. And he was actually the captain in the Mexican army, which is really cool. So he does play a prominent role in Red Dead Redemption. And I'd venture to say that Michael DeSanta's last name is kind of paying homage to this character. And who knows, maybe he's related to him somehow. Now this next one can be found in Sandy Shores at the bar. And if we go inside, we can actually see a couple different plaques on the wall. We've got one that says Best of Show 2008. And if we actually take a look at what's on this plaque, we can see a motorcycle. And there's two of these. And this is an actual reference to the Lost and Damned GTA 4's motorcycle expansion DLC, like where you play as a biker, Johnny Klebitz. We all know what happens to him. And then if we take a look at this other plaque, it says Best of Show 2010. And it has like a wagon wheel on it. And this is an obvious reference to Red Dead Redemption, because the game, it was released in 2010. Best of Show for that year, and it's got a wagon wheel. I don't think it really gets any more oblivious than that. So this one is really cool. It's one of those minor ones that you guys might not have known about. Now moving on, we've got the Tree of Skulls. And I'm not going to drop any huge spoilers if you've never played Red Dead Redemption, but inevitably this tree is revealed to us at the end of the game. That's as far as I'm going to go with that. And in GTA 5, in the Grapeseed area, we can actually find the same tree reused within the game. And just a really cool reference here to Red Dead Redemption. I'm sure it's one of those things Rockstar just put in the game to see if anybody would notice, any diehard fans. I think it was more than just simply reusing a texture, which Rockstar has done before, but in this case, being that this is like one of the only spots the tree appears in, I'd say this is another oblivious reference to Red Dead Redemption. Now, in the mission called Daddy's Little Girl, where Michael and Jimmy go down to Vespucci Beach and have like a bike race, upon coming up to this bike stand where we can get these bikes to race, we actually come across the man, I guess, who owns it or runs it, and he's actually wearing a very cool John Marston shirt, and we can take a look at him here. And it's kind of hard to get a close-up of it, because if we pull out our gun, it'll spook him, and we got to restart the mission. But nonetheless, he's wearing this really cool John Marston shirt, and this is something that I think would be cool if Rockstar would add to the warehouse and actually sell these shirts. How cool would that be? Now, I'm sure you guys all knew about this one. This is like one of the first Easter eggs ever found within GTA 5. It can be found in pretty much any safe house and just any enterable interior. Most of the time, there's like bookshelves and just miscellaneous items and things on these. And in pretty much every one of these, there's a book called Red Dead. and the author is J. Dot Marston. So that's just a very obvious Easter egg there. We've got the book Red Dead by John Marston. So that is really, really cool. Definitely one of my favorites in the game. And moving on, in downtown Los Santos, we can actually find some storage units. That's actually what these are. I never knew what they were, but yeah, they're storage units, and there's a bunch of different murals and just paintings on these walls of these units. And upon one, there is a man or a cowboy riding a horse in the nighttime. Just a very pretty mural, I'd like to say. And this one's been around for years, and I've always heard people say that this is John Marston riding a horse, so I'm going to go ahead and stay with that story and hold it to be true and just say, hey, this is John Marston on this horse. So another very cool reference and Easter egg to John Marston here, and definitely one of my favorites. Now, if we go out to Sandy Shores, this is one of those minor ones, but it's also very interesting. There are two streets named after towns from Red Dead Redemption. We have Chola Springs, and then we have Armadillo Avenue. And just riding around Sandy Shores, you can actually find these streets. And like I said before, these are very minor Easter eggs, but these ones are very cool as well. And it just shows you the lengths the Rockstar goes to include these things in their games. And if you don't know how to check out the street names, they should appear in the bottom right corner of your screen when you turn on to pretty much any street. Now, while we're on the topic of these towns and boroughs from Red Dead Redemption being used as street names, there's another one, and it can be found in Los Santos by the airport, and it's actually Escalera Rent-A-Car. And you can rent shuttle buses and different things like that. And it's this business named after Escalera, this borough, or just this settlement within Red Dead Redemption. And what's cool about this one is that this one is actually in the Mexico side of Red Dead Redemption. So that's a very cool place. It was actually one of my favorite settlements to go to within Red Dead Redemption. I just love the scenery. And the Mexico side of the story was actually my favorite. Now up next, we've got probably the coolest one out of this whole video, and it's a treasure hunt added into GTA Online. And this was recently in December 2017. It's a treasure hunt. You follow it, you find some clues, and you unlock a secret weapon from Red Dead Redemption 2, a game that is not even out yet. And then you can also unlock a variant of this weapon in Red Dead Redemption 2 when it comes out as well, if your social club accounts are linked. The treasure hunt's very cool. If you haven't done it yet, I'd highly advise you to do so. So we've got this gun. That's one Easter egg. And then another one is, of course, back to the Tree of Skulls, where we go. And during this treasure hunt, there's different clues around the map. And one of these clues is actually at the base of the Tree of Skulls, further solidifying like Rockstar saying, hey, this is another Red Dead Redemption Easter egg in GTA 5. Next up, we've got John Marston's parent model, which can be used in GTA Online. A fun fact, this was actually part of the GTA 5 Collector's Edition originally. And then Rockstar just added this parent model into the game for us to be able to use. So that's pretty cool. He's not physically in the game, but we do see his picture in the character creation screen, which is cool just to kind of see John Marston and what he would look like in GTA 5, because he seems to be like wearing civilian-esque clothes. So yep, we've got John Marston as a parent model in GTA Online. Now, if we move on to the Bigfoot Hunter, this man appears in the side mission called The Last One. And basically what he is an exact character copy from a character from Red Dead Redemption's Undead Nightmare, I believe. And this dude is literally the exact same. I've talked about him before, from his fake eyeball to his outfit and the fact that he's hunting Sasquatch. The Last One mission in and of itself is a huge Easter egg to Red Dead Redemption's Undead Nightmare. But as far as this hunter goes, it's crazy to think that there is a character from Red Dead Redemption inside of GTA 5. Same voice actor, same everything. He appears in this game, and he's a very mysterious character, very weird one in both games, and he's definitely one of my favorite side characters. Now, last up, we have some cinematics from Red Dead Redemption, and they can be found on in-game commercials as well as in-game movies at the cinema. And the first one is from a movie called Capilavaro, and this can be found or watched at any cinema between 1 and 5 o'clock, I believe. And it's a very weird film, but in this film, there's a couple different screenshots and instances where gameplay from Red Dead Redemption is used, as well as this next one, which can be found on an in-game Pisswasser commercial. And once again, we see just different scenes and settings from Red Dead Redemption used, which is very, very cool. Now, with all 14 of those Easter eggs covered, this pretty much sums up most, if not all, of the Red Dead Redemption Easter eggs within GTA 5. Hopefully you guys found the video enjoyable. If so, be sure to give it a thumbs up. Like I said, let's try and break 1,000 likes. Be sure to subscribe to never miss out on some more daily video game content. And if you are excited for Red Dead Redemption 2 like me, be sure to let me know down below in the comment section. And if you guys would like to see some more Red Dead content on the channel, be sure to let me know. But with that said and out the way, I believe that's just about it. You guys all take it easy. Have a safe one. My name is Zach Cox, and I'll catch you guys in the next video.